everyone, and welcome to our Reformation TED Talk. Okay, so today I want to talk about Erich Schoenbrenn. And the first, I want to show you the background of Brighton. Okay, when you look at the picture, and could you rest how old is she? How old is she? 40? Okay, almost 60, because she has, the red hair like this. And when was she born? She was born in 1951. But she, I'm really so sad to talk about the passed away in 2013. Okay, and Steve came from Texas in the East End. Okay, and the achievement of her doctorate of education, and she lived in the traditional family of education. But she, and she wanted to do a manager about a consultant director reservoir, but finally she to the educator. And what will she have? She contributes in the education, and she contributes to many training for the education in the US generally and particularly in the world. Okay, in the first video, she showed many problems about the student and the teacher, the kids and the people. And she wondered many questions about why, just why, because some she don't know why the kids drop out, this new cut of life, and the second about learn. Why do kids don't learn? But she answer by herself, and she show many answers. The lesson is so boring, maybe the one problem. And poverty, this means many kids so poor and they lack a condition to study. But the other influence affect them. And one problem we never discussed about the human connection. And human connection, what does it mean? I talk about the final that our my presentation today. First thing, when I watched the video, I realized she showed many experience in class, and we need to learn the first ratio, it's been related to math subject. And the second, she mentioned a queen in her class. Okay, and I will talk racial math. And when you see a teacher, and she has 40 years for teaching, was when she went to this lab and she did wrong. Okay, and what do you resolve in this situation? And when she realized she taught wrong, and so the next day she came to this lab and she also said sorry. Okay, and when I look back myself, if I did wrong in Vietnam, maybe I don't mention about this. I will focus on the migration. And when we are adults, mean growing up, and we never say sorry for a kiss. Okay, especially in Vietnam. And the next one is parent. She emphasize a quick because a student in her class. Okay, and she organized a quiz for them about transition. But a student missed out the 18 questions. Okay, and it looked like get the point F. And the point F in Vietnam is the low score. And when you look at the low score, maybe, okay, you call their parent, the first or the second, maybe you get out my class, or something like that. And we have many punishment for the point F. But to her, when he has a F score, yeah, she always support him, and she often say, "You can do it for the next time, okay?" And fighting for the next time, something like this, with a big smile, okay. And to me, when my student has the F score, it makes me angry and maybe annoyed. Yeah, I don't like it. But about her, she always support them. So how about experience? When I watch the video, I realize we need to say sorry if we have a mistake. Yes. And the second, we need to support them, never give up them. Yeah, this is the two experience, maybe valuable for me. And the topic, every kid needs a champion. And when I mention a champion, and I make sure many people think a champion is mean a winner. Yeah, or a big ride in the competition, but it's not. And why do we need to be a champion in the kids? And when you look at the picture, you see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and many the arm of the people, and the leg people, the white people, or the yellow people, but they hold hands together. This means human connection. And when you want to be a champion in the kids, you need to have a human connection. So human connection is mean you connect between the teacher and the student and a kids. And when we connect together, this means a big team, and you can fight for the many challenges in the next future. The second relationship. So, and want to be a champion, you need to build relationship between our member of this class. And when we have a good relationship, I make sure the student is open mind and they are ready to help you or help himself. Yeah. And understanding, why I mentioned understanding to be a champion, and in a team or in class, we need to understand together. So, and I mentioned earlier about the F score, yeah. If we don't understand, and maybe suddenly we smack a kid or a student so far, and maybe they don't make an effort in the future, and understanding play a vital role for achievement. Finally, I emphasize apologizing. And in Vietnam, apologizing is not popular in the class. And I mentioned about, yeah, I mentioned about what? Yeah, a racial map, because when we this wrong, we maybe sometimes some people apologize, but to me, I never apologize for kids. And when I realized the video, I learned many things in a chamber. Okay, again, human connection, relationship, understanding, and final apologizing. Okay, when you look at this picture, there are so many words on the board, but I want to say some best of things, the most favorite thing I like. The first, kids don't learn from people they don't like. Again, I think it is totally right, because when I work kids, if I
don't like the teacher and want to learn. So, and right now I'm a teacher. We need to understanding, apologizing, give me connection, and be a relationship. So keep don't learn from people they don't like. This is the most favorite message. And you see the key's work. Human connection is a key. Look like a key to open the door. And you can come step out the next door. And human connection play a vital role. It's necessary for our class. Okay, the final. Teaching and learning should bring joy. And when I'm a teacher, we need to relate funny atmosphere in the class, and when we are happy, everything is so easy. But when we are sad or angry, and other students or other kids don't want to learn. Okay. Yeah, and this is our presentation. Okay, thank you for your attending.
Okay.
And now, can you make clear the relationship between the teacher and student in the class and give me some example to make clear us?
Okay, we talk about understanding.
Relationship.
Okay, I'm so sorry, relationship. Okay, we make a difference between I'm a teacher, you are a student. We need to have a distance, right? But we just interact together. And relationship, this means I want to say to be the closest relationship to resolve the problem. Yeah, I see. For example, I don't know, it's hot. Yeah, and so when we lay, do you want to lay well? This means you want, right? But we don't have a relationship, and when you lay, okay, it's okay, and when I lay, okay, I don't care, yeah. And it's suddenly we have distance. Okay, let's see.
Have you ever built a relationship with your student?
You?
Yes,
I'm just a teacher for 2 or 3 years, but I try to build a relationship because when I had teacher in the this last year, yeah, and the first time I'm a homeroom teacher, and so in that time maybe I don't understand about them and they don't understand me. So, and that years we interact together, and I always listen to them. And maybe if they have a problem, I always help them. Yeah, this is the relationship between them.
Yeah.
Okay.
What do you usually bring joy for the student in your classroom?
The joy thing is the small. Okay, for example, when they have a good lesson. When they have good lesson and they review a lesson so well that I'm ready to give them the 10 point or the 9 point. Okay, and small happy, I think it is so helpful for them and they can enjoy the whole joy.
Can you tell me why you don't say that you are a
okay, maybe I don't know because I'm a growing up man, so and this look like my eye look like a baby. And when I say sorry to them, I'm shy. Yeah, and I don't like it. But right now after the video, I need to my mistake. And when I have a mistake for the next time about the kiss of everyone, I need to say sorry.
Okay.